Hey everybody, this is Nick. A really quick Excel tip for you. This is really helpful if you are creating spreadsheets or workbooks with complicated formulas in them and you want to be able to share the formula with somebody else as a reference and put it in as text. So right here, you can see down here in row 16, I have the margin of error formula for 95% confidence interval, and this is what that text looks like. Now, it starts with an equal sign, so we know that in Excel, if we normally type something that starts with an equal sign, it's going to create a function or a formula in that cell for us automatically. But how can I get this text to be exactly like this? Well, there is a function for it, and it's just called formula text. So all we need to do right here, you can see in this column, I have my margin of error calculated. And in this case, you can see the formula bar right up here. This is the margin of error calculation for a 90% confidence interval. So I want to put that here in this cell right here, 15, B15. So what we're going to do is we're just going to type equal and then type formula text, one word, formula. And you can see it pops up right here. It says returns a formula as a string. So I'm going to double click that. And then it's saying, which cell do you want me to return as a string? I'm going to point to my margin of error right there, close the parenthesis, push enter, and there is my margin of error calculation text right there. Now, you can see that this is still an active function right here. If we want to get rid of that, all we have to do is copy that and then paste it in as values. And you can use the shortcut Control Shift V for that now in Excel. So Control Shift V, and now you can see in the formula bar, it's changed to values. And these are no longer functions or formulas. So that is a pretty cool tip, and I think it will be very helpful in any sort of education setting or teaching setting where you're trying to teach people different formulas and you want to include those in the workbook as text. I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to click that subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you all next time.